Ravioli, ravioli, what's in the pocket-oli? Yesterday we had ourselves a Montreal Canadiens game that did not see Tyler Toffoli. He is out until Sunday with a lower body injury, and that is absolutely tragic. But what we did see was a top line of Yoel Armia, Nick Suzuki, and none other than Cole Caufield. And today I just wanted to talk a little bit about the future. Not so much about the playoffs, because yes, the playoffs are happening. We have ourselves a matchup, Montreal versus Toronto. It's going to be big. But aside from that, I still wanted to talk about the potential and how exactly things have gone for Suzuki and Caufield together with this Tyler Toffoli thing affecting the team. But before we go over any of that, thank you to those in the comments of the previous video who commented Philip Zadina. I did see a comment that I really just kind of want to hash out, though. Yeah, try not to skip to the end just for the thing, because, yeah, that's kind of lame, to be honest. I appreciate those who actually watch the videos and, you know, stick around with it. Obviously, I have no way of determining who does that and who doesn't, who actually watches all the way through, but at the end of the day, we're making videos here. We need to get watch time up. That's how YouTube runs with this algorithm. So for those of you who are commenting and who are showing your support by watching the videos all the way through, hey, that's helping out the algorithm a ton. That means a lot. But we will indeed just have our normal system of doing a comment section keyword at the end of this video if you want a chance to be featured potentially in the next one. Today we're talking about Suzuki and Caufield, because yesterday against the Edmonton Oilers, yes, we know the Habs, they ended up losing again. Don't really know how confident too many Canadiens fans are in terms of facing the Maple Leafs and potentially the Edmonton Oilers or the Jets should the Canadiens actually beat the Maple Leafs, which I don't really know if that's really too possible anymore either. But let's just talk about Suzuki and Caufield, eh, shall we? Because yesterday we had ourselves that line, as we said, Armia, Suzuki, Caufield, and things got off to a very nice start, because 2 minutes into the game, it's Yoel Armia in a puck battle down low. Eventually, the Oilers take it, and they send it up the boards. Caufield is there, he picks it off, he comes in, he shoots, and he scores. What a great goal there by Cole Caufield, his fourth on the season. And the Canadiens take a 1-0 lead. We also had ourselves later on a goal from Nick Suzuki shorthanded to give the Canadiens the 2-1 lead. He just comes in, picks the puck off the boards, dashes down to the other side, shoots it, and he scores. What a beautiful snipe there by Nick Suzuki. And then later on in the game, we had ourselves in the third period, Suzuki and Caufield combining for a goal. This one was beautiful. It's Cole Caufield off an Edmonton turnover in the offensive zone, picking the puck up, centering it out for Suzuki, and Suzuki gets the backhand deflection in there. Caufield gets his first multi-point game in the National Hockey League. Nick Suzuki with 2 goals on this one as well. Sure, the Canadiens lost in overtime, but hey, we're not talking about the Canadiens of today. We're talking about the long-term potential of Suzuki and Caufield. We always kind of knew ever since Nick Suzuki was a prospect before, even when he was in the Guelph Storm system in the OHL, we always kind of knew that this was a guy that excelled at more than one thing out there on the ice. His two-way play took a big step in his last year in the OHL, but we always knew that the handles, the playmaking, the offensive point production for Suzuki, those were always really good things within his game, and it's why the Vegas Golden Knights took him where they did in the 2017 NHL entry draft. But throughout his time as a Montreal Canadiens prospect, he worked on the two-way game, he worked on his sniping ability, he worked on all the other things that had room to improve upon before stepping into the NHL. And if you take a look at where exactly Nick Suzuki has gone from then to now, hey, his second year in the NHL definitely had no sophomore slump whatsoever, because he matched his total point production in, what is that, 15 fewer games? He's got 2 more goals than he did last year, he's at the same number of assists pretty much, he's got the same amount of points, and the Montreal Canadiens are a lot better of a team because of Nick Suzuki's overall development. The guys like Jake Allen said it themselves, man, Nick Suzuki is playing like a number one center. And despite the fact that Suzuki and Toffoli has been such a good pairing, you didn't have that last night. He had Cole Caufield instead, a guy whose overall package as a hockey player is honestly kind of underrated, because everybody talks about Caufield and the shot, the goal scoring. Caufield's definitely doing that at the NHL level. Take a look at what he is at. 10 games played, he's got 5 points, he's got 4 goals. In the AHL, 2 games played, hey, guess what? 3 goals over there. And of course, with the Wisconsin Badgers, 30 goals in 31 games. Yeah, we always knew he was a goal scorer, but As we had been seeing in the limited sample size with the Canadiens, his two-way ability honestly is pretty good. There were a few chances that opposing teams have had that were literally thwarted by Caulfield and only Caulfield because of solid backchecking or solid defensive awareness. Along with the underrated playmaking ability that Caulfield has, he's just a guy who gets the game. He knows how to play, especially as a guy who is only 5'7", he knows how to play the game the way that he needs to in order to be an effective hockey player at both ends of the ice. And to think, he's only 20. So with Caulfield and Suzuki being paired together right here, with Tyler Toffoli out, it's getting me really excited as to how exactly the long-term future is going to bode for both of these guys. We initially thought, I would say a few years ago, that if you have Caulfield with a Kotkaniemi, Kotkaniemi is a really good playmaker, we'll see how exactly those two are able to blossom together. But I mean, Suzuki is kind of in that position where you kind of have that same conversation today, right? Our previous videos for the Canadiens have gone over Kotkaniemi specifically and talking about how you could argue that he is not really being developed the right way, but at the same time, he is a third overall pick, he's still extraordinarily young, he's still got a lot of time for sure. But with Suzuki already, man, it's making things really difficult to try to project where exactly Caulfield lines up on in the long-term future with these Canadiens and their centers. We always knew Suzuki Kotkaniemi would be the 1-2 punch, but hey, where does Caulfield play? The fact that you have Tyler Toffoli on this team for the next few years as well makes things a lot easier, because if you wanted to say, okay, Caulfield, you can just play with Kotkaniemi, Eric Staal is gone next year, let's move Kotkaniemi up in the lineup, give him more minutes, actually give him power play time, and we'll have Caulfield playing with this guy while Toffoli does his thing with Suzuki. You could legitimately have yourselves two really capable scoring lines if Kotkaniemi is able to play to the way that we know he can, and you have Suzuki and Toffoli doing their thing. If you want to play mix and match, hey, Kotkaniemi was playing with Toffoli earlier on in the year. He had that Vancouver series where Toffoli was absolutely going off, and Kotkaniemi played a very big part of that. So have Suzuki with Caulfield and maybe even just Armia, you keep that line together because it was so good last night. You have those guys together while you have Toffoli back. Is this a winning formula not just in the long term, but hey, maybe even in the playoffs? A lot of conversations to explore when it comes to moving around the pieces the Canadiens have and trying to build chemistry in the long term. Because Caulfield, I mean, he's really good now. 30 goals, 31 games played, whole bunch of goals in the AHL and in the NHL, but he's only 20, so he's going to be better. And the fact that you could realistically say the same thing about Kotkaniemi and Suzuki too, hey man, it's getting me really, really hyped. This is why it was always so exciting to make videos about Canadiens prospects. Back in 2018, 2019-ish, we had a whole bunch of people asking me, hey Lego, why are you making so many videos about the Canadiens? Aren't the Canucks your favorite team? And yes, the Canucks are my favorite team, but just talking about prospects, man, that's a really, really fun part of making these videos, just going over the future, the potential, and talking about the future of the sport that I love here, you know? Makes things a lot easier because Mark Bergevin's going out there acquiring these guys. Cole Caulfield, 15th overall, Nick Suzuki traded for Pacioretty, with, of course, Tatar and the draft pick being included there as well. Yeah, pretty good stuff. If you're a Canadiens fan, though, just do me a favor and not check out the Jesperi Kotkaniemi reaction draft video we made, because yeah, even though I definitely am a big believer in Kotkaniemi, and that fact has been well documented on this channel as well, the fact that he did go third overall did really irk me at the time, because I was really on that Zadina hype train, so yeah, that's kind of my own perspective about that. But aside from Kotkaniemi and Toffoli, Ravioli, Caulfield and Suzuki are doing wonders together. It's been a short sample size, I get that, but it still has been awesome to watch. And for Cole Caulfield heading into the 2020 Stanley Cup playoffs, or excuse me, 2021 Stanley Cup playoffs, yeah, it's 2021, what in the world? This could be the potential Cale Makar break-in moment that a guy like this needs. Give him free reign, no concerns about the cap, you see that he is doing well in the first line with Suzuki, you say to yourself, okay, let's keep him there. Toffoli Kotkaniemi was working out really well at the beginning of the year, why not try that out again? Unless, of course, they say, okay, here, Eric Staal, you play with Toffoli instead. We'll just bury Kotkaniemi into the lineup like we had been the previous few weeks, because, hey, why not? It's a winning formula, right? I'm being sarcastic there, by the way. If you made it to the end of this video, comment down in the comment section below Max Pacioretty, because he's the guy who was traded over to Vegas for that Nick Suzuki package. Also, Please comment down in the comments if you're commenting Max Pacioretty. If you actually made it to the end of the video and you didn't just skip, that's something that I would like to see more truthfulness on. So if you don't mind adding that little extra step, then hey, I would really appreciate it. Talk to me in the comments though what you think about the future, Suzuki, Caulfield, how they're playing without Toffoli. Obviously they lost, I get that, but still, there are some good things to talk about when it comes to Caulfield and his overall package, because yeah, we've been talking about this guy and his profile as a hockey player for a long time now, and I don't really think that's going to stop anytime soon. Talk to me in the comments if you enjoyed. This was Ash Rose 99. And bye.